Good morning, my dear students. How are you all? This is your maths teacher, Neha ma'am. As you all know, we are doing chapter number 2 from your maths course book, that is whole numbers. And in the previous video, we have studied in detail about what are whole numbers, what is number line, and how we can perform various mathematical operations of whole number on number line. I hope you have tried to solve different questions from exercise 2.1 of your book. Now, today we will study about different properties of whole numbers, that how different properties are applied to different mathematical operations on whole number. Now, let's continue with the same. Now, students,
we are going to discuss the properties of whole numbers in detail one by one. The first one is closure property. Closure property is satisfied whenever a particular mathematical operation applied in the any two whole numbers or more whole numbers, the result which comes after applying the particular operation is also a whole number. Now, what we are going to do is we are going to check the same closure property for all the mathematical operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. So, let's consider it for addition first. For addition, sum of two whole numbers is also a whole number. Let me explain it to you with the help of an example like 2 plus 3. What is the answer? 5. Now, when I added these two whole numbers, the answer was again a whole number because we know 5 is also a whole number. That means when we are applying this mathematical operation of addition on these two whole numbers, the answer is again coming out to be a whole number. So, we can conclude that addition of whole numbers is closed. That means closure property holds good for the addition of whole numbers. So, I hope you are clear with this, children. Now, let's check the same closure property for subtraction. Now, this closure property does not hold good for whole numbers all the time. That means, let me explain it to you by taking few examples. Now, let's take an example. 3 minus 2. What is the answer? 1. Now, I took these two whole numbers and I got the result to be 1. That was again a whole number. That means the closure property is holding good in this case. But in some case, like let me consider another example. 5 minus 12. Now 5 and 12 both are whole numbers and I am applying the operation subtraction on them. 5 minus 12, I'll get the answer as minus 7. Now, is minus 7 a whole number? No. That means my closure property does not hold good for subtraction. Now, let's move on to the third mathematical operation, multiplication. Now, the product of two whole numbers is also a whole number. Let me explain it to you with the help of an example. I am considering any two whole numbers like 9 and 3 and I am multiplying them and I will get the answer as 27, which is again a whole number. And let us take another example like 20 multiplied by 5. 20 multiplied by 5 is 100. 100 is again a whole number. That means we can say that whenever we are multiplying any two whole numbers, we are getting the result again a whole number. That means the multiplication operation of whole numbers is closed. So, I hope, children, you are clear about the meaning of this closure property in detail. Now, let's apply the same property to another mathematical operation, division. So, whenever we divide two whole numbers, the result is not necessarily a whole number. That means the division of whole number is not closed. Let us take few examples and understand this. Now, let me take a number 4 and divide it by 16. What will I get? I will get 1 by 4, which is not a whole number. Let's take some another example like 20 divided by 5. The answer is 4. That means it is a whole number. Now what we can see that closure property is holding here in case of these two numbers, but not holding in case of the first example. So, and in our case, we want that the closure property should apply on each and every number on being divided. So the conclusion will be that division operation of whole numbers is not closed, because whenever we are concluding that the property is applicable to whole number, it should apply to each and every kind of whole number. So I hope, children, with this you are clear with the closure property. Now let's move on to the second property, which is commutative property. Commutative means that whenever any mathematical operation is applied to whole numbers, the answer is not affected by changing the order of the whole numbers. Now I'll explain it to you in detail by considering a particular operation like addition. Let me take an example like 3 plus 5. Now these are two whole numbers, 3 and 5, and I'll add them. I have taken 3 first and 5 later on. What is my answer? 8. Now in the second step, what I'll do, I'll change the order of these two numbers. I'll take 5 first and 3 later on. Now children, what will be my answer? Again, 8 will be my answer. Now tell me, when I change the order of these two numbers, 3 and 5, in the first and the second case, is my answer affected from it? No, my answer is not affected. That means commutative property hold goods for addition. That means addition of whole numbers is commutative. That means when we are applying the operation addition on the numbers, my answer is not getting affected. So my addition is commutative. Now let's make it more clear by taking another example like 40 plus 60. I have taken 40 first and 60 later on. What is my answer? 100. Now I'll change the order, 60 first and 40 later on. What is my answer? 100. So adding of these two whole numbers in the changed order does not affect my answer. So my addition is commutative. I hope you have understood what do you mean by commutative. Now we will check the same property for the another mathematical operation, that is subtraction. Let me make it more clear to you by taking an example like 5 minus 3. Now 5 and 3 both are whole numbers, and what will I get after subtracting 5 and 3? I'll get, when I subtract 3 from 5, I'll get 2. Now what will I do? I'll change the order. I will take 3 first and 5 later on with the subtraction sign in between them. So what will be my answer in this case? My answer will be minus 2. So children, is my answer same in both the cases? No. That means when I change the order of the whole numbers and on having a subtraction operation in between them, my answer is not same. That means commutative property does not hold good for subtraction. The next mathematical operation is multiplication. Commutative property hold goods for multiplication. Let's take an example like 15 into 2. Now I have taken 15 whole number first and 2 whole number later on. What is my answer? 30. Now what I'll do? I'll change the order of these two numbers. I'll take 2 first and 15 later on and find the answer. The answer will again be 30. Now children, my answer is not affected by changing the order of these two numbers. That means multiplication of whole numbers is commutative. Let's consider one more example like 75 into 3. Now I'll multiply 75 and 3. What will be my answer? 225. Now what will I do? I will change the order of these two numbers again. Take 3 first and 75 later on. What will be my answer? My answer will again be 225 in this case. That means my answer is not affected when I have changed the order of these two whole numbers. So from here I can conclude that commutative property hold good for multiplication of whole numbers. Now next mathematical operation for which we are going to check the commutative property is division. Let's take a simple example like 8 divided by 2. When I take 8 first and 2 later on, my answer will be 4. Now what will I do? I'll change the order of these two numbers. I'll take 2 first and 8 later on. In this case, what will be my answer? My answer will be 0.25. Now children, is my answer same in both the cases? No, my answer is not same when I change the order of these two whole numbers. That means commutative property does not hold good for division of whole numbers. So with this children, I hope that you have clearly understood what is the meaning of closure property and what is the meaning of commutative property. Now we will make it more clear by taking some examples from exercise 2.2 of your maths course book. This is a question from exercise 2.2 of your book. 208 is first and 1076 is placed after the addition. And on the right hand side, 1076 is placed first and 208 is placed after addition. Now even without making the actual addition of these two numbers, we can conclude whether that statement is true or not. Why? Using which property? Now tell me which property you will use. Yes, you will use commutative property. Now here what we have done? We have studied that addition is commutative. That means on changing the order, addition is not affected. So we will write the statement is true. Now next is an example of subtraction, 40 minus 72 and 70 minus 40. Now here again the case is same, that they have simply changed the order of the numbers in the left hand side and right hand side. But what is the mathematical operation here? It is subtraction, and we have studied the subtraction is not commutative. That means that changing the order of the numbers will change the answers. So will the answer be same? No, the answer will not be same. So the statement is not true. Next is 75 multiplied by 42 and 42 multiplied by 7. Here we can see that the mathematical operation is multiplication, and they have changed the order of the numbers in left hand side and right hand side. And we have already studied that multiplication is commutative. That means my answer on the left hand side and right hand side is not being affected by keeping 75 first or 75 later on. So my this statement is true. Next also is an example of multiplication, so children you can easily solve them. Here they have changed the order of the whole numbers on left hand side and right hand side, but the operation in between them is multiplication, and multiplication is commutative, so my statement will be true. Now let's consider one statement problem related to the same property from exercise 2.2 of your book. The question is, Anish and Ahmed started reading a storybook. On the first day, Anish read 127 pages, and on the second day, he read 79 pages. And Ahmed, he read 79 pages on first day and 127 pages on second day. Who read more number of pages? That means we have to calculate the total number of pages read by Anish and Ahmed. So what will I write? I'll write number of pages Anish read on first day, 127. Number of pages he read on second day, 79. So how can I find out total pages? By adding these two numbers. The answer will be 127 plus 79. But children, even without calculating the answer of this addition, we can tell them that who read more number of pages by using the property. Now let's see. I will write the same statement for Ahmed as well, that he read 79 number of pages on first day and 127 number of pages on second day. So his total number of pages will be 79 plus 127. So Anish has read 127 plus 79 pages, and Ahmed has read 79 plus 127 pages. So who has read more? Now what we have read in our commutative property, children, that commutative property says addition is commutative. Now you can see here that numbers 127, 127, 79, 79. Numbers are same for both Anish and Ahmed, but just the order is changed. That 127 was first day for Anish and it was second day for Ahmed. That means we can easily use the commutative property for this case and tell our answer. So our answer will be same in both the cases, and we can easily write both read equal pages. So children, I hope you are clear with the statement problems. And now what you have to do is, you have to practice similar questions from exercise 2.2 of your book, which will be provided to you in a PDF. So today we have completed two properties of whole numbers. Revise them thoroughly and practice more questions. Thank you.